Happy Halloween, goblins and ghouls. And what better way to celebrate Halloween than watching a couple spooky flicks with a couple of friends? Well, they're running a little bit late tonight, but, you know, it's only Halloween for so long, so we'll get the first one out of the way. I'm sure they won't mind. We're gonna be watching The Swordsman. Here, Frankie, put it in for me. I'm gonna do that throughout the whole movie.
Shut the fuck up.
What up, fool?
What's up, bro?
What you doing?
Nothing. Just chilling.
Cool. Well, I got something to show you.
Whoa!
I found it in the backyard last night.
Oh, shit.
I heard a loud-ass noise, so I went to investigate. As I got closer, I saw bright lights. It was weird. It's like it's been there for years.
Damn, bro, that's spooky, man. Hopefully it's nothing, though.
Yeah.
Anyways, bro, I got some new shit. You want to get... Payday, bro.
Shit tastes like some strong medicine. You good?
Where everyone go?
You know what they call me? They call me the Drake.
You fool. You should have just given me the sword.
You're never getting this sword.
You think I'm gonna let you in, but so stop me. For someone to find that sword. You see, long ago, my men and I were raiding a village. Even killing some of the women and children. We were being cut down. Trying to flee, I was killed. And my soul was binded to that sword as punishment.
You coward!
Oh shit! It's just Gary.
It's Gary.
What up, fool?
What's up, buddy?
Fellas, you might want to sit down.
So what is it, bro?
It's the Bonergeist.
Well,
Wow, those tweakers are always up to something, Right, Frankie? Why don't you even bother talking to you?
Fuck you.
Get out of me. Well, they're still not here. But, you know, traffic's always kind of busy during Halloween. You know, it wouldn't hurt to just watch one more movie. Paranormal Activity. Take it away, Frankie.
What's up, guys? I'm here with my boy Habibi, and there's been some pretty weird shit going on in our house. A lot of paranormal rat activities. You know, I'm waking up with like holes in my shirts and stuff from like rats, and it's just like it's fucked up. It's like some weird.
Is that fucking cheese?
So. Last night we were hearing some really weird noises. Sounded like maracas. What the fuck? Do you hear that?
The fuck?
It's the... Dude.
I think there's fucking rats in the walls.
So essentially last night, me and Habibi here set up, we set up, cameras. Cause we were fucking and watching furry porn. So, what you're about to see right now is all the bullshit this fucking rat did. So here's what we found last night.
Nigga, these niggas bleed different. We don't bleed, nigga. We make niggas bleed blood. Trey Wayne,
these niggas that hurt me, I ain't hurting you. Get the fuck out my fucking face, I'm hurting you. Bitch, niggas on my face.
This is our roommate, Todd. What do you have to say about all this?
Dude, sick fucking blinker, dude.
Okay, yeah, but this fucking rat ghost, he's a fucking brujo. He stood a broom up all by himself. All on its own.
Cheese.
Did he fucking throw cheese on the wall? Hey, Walton.
What up, man?
I'm looking up methods on how to get rid of the rat ghost, and the three that look the most effective are. It's saying to the three ways to get rid of a rat ghost are an exorcism, sprinkling rat poison in front of the door to get to keep it out, and cheese offerings, I guess. You know, just what do you want to try first?
Bro, Habibi, what the fuck are you doing, bro?
What the fuck?
Dude, that's rat poison, not coke, bro. The coke is in the fucking closet.
What? Wait, what?
Also, that shit over there is less of a fence, so don't even do it. That was just for the homeless people outside. We We've been having like squatters and shit, Todd, and like we just like got we got some fentanyl laced coke, and we're just gonna give it to the homeless for free.
Todd, I don't fucking care that you just heard me talk about genocide. Todd, I swear to God, it'll be the first one. Wah, wah, wah.
Todd, you're such a fucking pussy.
See? Hopefully this keeps the ghost out.
Hey, why are you good,
Yeah, I just got fucking poisoned by that rat, bruh.
Fucked up. I was trying to go get hot.
on what?
On some DMT, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, we gotta go set up the, cheese.
The cheese?
Remember, we had the fucking cheese offerings.
Oh, yeah, the
that
cheese
can't, offering. That one can't go wrong.
It can't go wrong.
Dude, Walton. Did you see the fucking, did you see the diss track the rap made on you?
What?
Yeah,
the diss track?
Yeah, you gotta see.
What the fuck? Hey, yo, I don't mean to be racist to you, bro, but fuck rats, bro.
That was me. I'm gonna take that.
Bro, what the fuck, bro?
Yeah, no, fuck this. We gotta slide back on that rat. Switch up the exorcism steps.
Right now.
Okay, so it says right here.
What the fuck is this? This is Yip!
It says right here that, it says right here, you need to fucking bring forth what a rat loves most. Cheese, the bubonic plague, and a picture of New York City. I will go and gather these three fucking artifacts.
Let's do it.
So, we have gathered the things... Three things
rats love the most? New York City. The bubonic plague. Jeez.
Look at me.
Shit. Now it's time. Rat ghost. Rat ghost. Rat ghost.
Rat ghost.
What?
Todd?
Todd, what the fuck?
Hey, guys.
Todd, what the fuck?
You're the guy?
Yeah, put that up. Hey, guys. How you doing?
You fucking made that discharge, Todd? You made that discharge?
Hey.
Why are you laughing?
Hey, man. Take it easy. Take it easy.
Why are you here? Why are you here, rat ghost?
It hasn't been easy for me this last couple of months. I'm just trying to get some levity after my son died.
Damn, man, sorry to hear that.
Yeah, ever since they overturned Rat v. Wade. Ever since they turned over Rat v. Wade, my rat wife couldn't bear our child in a safe manner and get him aborted. Mm. She died right on that Cat Denny's poster.
Wait, what?
What poster?
Oh, you mean the goon material?
Give me that! Don't be touching my things.
That picture has been gooned on more times than you could count in your life ever.
It's so bad that it's turned fucking blue.
Walton. Walton, we're being fucking haunted.
That's all I have.
Walton, we're being haunted.
Walton.
You need to let go, man.
I know what it's like to lose a loved one. In fact, I lost him right here on this very corner that you're touching yourself to.
Walton.
You know, Todd, or Rat King, whatever. You have been nice, and I never thank you for that $1,300.
Okay. I just want to know that the diss track was impersonal. But with BB, your dick is very small. That was not a lie.
There you go. Go find your son or whatever.
I can't. Remember, abortions are not live, especially after the third trimester.
And also, if you're at 9 months... Wait! One last sesh.
Together?
Together. Yeah!
Goodbye, my friend. But that also means that I'm gonna pay rent for this month either.
Okay.
And also, by the way, I replaced that rat poison with cocaine. Bye!
Wait a minute, we sold that cocaine to Jimmy!
Wow, those rats were really something, huh? You know, the boys really would have loved that if they decided to show up, but... Oh well, looks like I'm watching the last one on my own. The witching hour. Put it in for me, Frankie. Shut fucking...
Witching Hour.
Are you hearing this shit? I'm just getting fucking tired of all these curated playlists that these restaurants are playing over the loudspeakers. I mean, whatever just happened to listening to the radio?
mean, it's safe. It's digestible. I mean, come on.
Why does it matter?
Why does it? Are you serious? Don't you think this age of streaming with this Spotify and Apple Music bullcrap is a bad thing?
People want to listen to what they want.
Yeah, and giving people what they want whenever they want is a bad thing. Just an endless boost of dopamine. That's why this generation's so unhappy. I mean, think about it. How good does it feel when you turn on the radio and a song you like comes on?
I don't listen to the radio.
Well, it feels fucking great. Because it's a surprise. I mean, who doesn't love surprises? You can't surprise yourself on Spotify.
Unless you get shuffled.
I mean, you can shuffle a deck of cards, but you still know what cards are in the deck. Now imagine shuffling a deck of cards and an Uno card comes out. Bam. Radio for you, baby.
Yeah.
That was Suavemente by Elvis Crespo. Now, time for commercial break. Strong medicine. Find it in a
may look like
a union just before profitable company.
Hour. Coming up is a little Billy Ocean to funk your soul.
The Witching Hour.
Song tonight is a special one. Let's hope you saved up some energy for today because we're playing Don't Go Breaking My Heart by Elton John and Kiki D.
Just before.
I'm telling you, it was the most surreal experience I've ever had in my entire life. So what if it plays late? Like, you have anything better to do? You know what? People like you are the reason radio's dying.
to the Witching Hour. Welcome back, listeners. If you're listening in right now, you're in luck. You caught the first song of the night, I Like It, by DeBarge.
Seems so satisfying to me, I must confess it, girl. When I like it.
Without listeners like you, we'd be unable to do what we do here. With that said, we're going to take a few callers. Who knows? Maybe you'll have the chance to win big. Call in at 812-WITCHING-HOUR. That's 812-WITCHING-HOUR. Caller 1, you're on the air.
Hey, I've been waiting fucking years to get on this show.
Well, I'm glad you made it. Anything you want to say to our audience listening in?
Yeah, I'm just so honest. Everyone in my life has called me crazy. Guess who's crazy now? Who's crazy now, Ma?
Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we have for you.
No, I have so much to say. I can't. I've been waiting 20 years for this. You can't.
Caller 2, you're on the air. Caller 1, you're on the air.
Hi, I just want to say...
Yeah, I love this show almost as much as I love Anna de Armas.
I really fucking hate, bro. All this modern music, awesome titties and...
I want to come on here and say, first...
I don't get why you can't just play some Dua Lipa or Olivia Rodrigo or something.
Caller number 6, you're on the air.
Don't listen. Don't listen to the show. You gotta get the f-
Sorry about the technical difficulties. We'll only be accepting one more caller for the rest of the night. Caller 7, you're on the air.
I can't believe this. This show changed my life.
Well, I'm glad.
I don't know what to say.
Well, we do. Caller number 7, you're our lucky winner.
No kidding.
You have a shot at being on our show. All you have to do is answer one simple question.
Yeah, what is it?
Are you ready to sacrifice everything for a shot at greatness?
Absolutely.
Then it's settled. All you have to do is...
Wally, I haven't heard from you in months. Like, what's going on with you?
I tried telling you. The radio show, it's amazing.
Oh, Christ, Wally, this bullshit.
It's not bullshit.
When the hell are you gonna grow out of this? No, seriously, dude. All you ever talk about is this radio crap that nobody cares about. I mean, you work a dead end minimum wage job. Have you ever stopped to think about your future once? don't know if I can watch you waste your life like this, dude. Did you just listen to a thing I just said? Wally? Wally?
Welcome, everybody. Today we have a special guest, the winner of last night's show. Our guest has a surprise for all of our listeners. Mr. Wally Walton, take it away.
Well, friends didn't show up, but, you know, there's always next Halloween. You know, I'm just glad I had... You know, I give you a lot of shit, Frankie, but I'm just glad I had someone to watch these with me.
Come on!
No, Frankie, you're not...
Fan-forced.
No, Frankie, you're not Josh Trank anymore. We've been over this.
Josh Trank.
No, Frankie, why does it... Oh, shit. Frankie, the police, they must have found my friends. I mean the bodies. I mean, fuck. We need to get out of here.
Yo, definition of Halloween as I die fast. Slicing up your throat and slicing up your ass. All in her mouth is my motherfucking pumpkin. Shitting on her chest like a motherfucking pumpkin. All in her cheese as it motherfucking drips. Faster and faster as I motherfucking stab. At the tip of my knife, I need rehab. Faster and faster as it's all going through. All my fucking candy inside of fucking you. As I hit it hard with the motherfucking power. Stomach fucking sprinkling like the witching hour. Punching that rich like Habibi got a small dick. Watching the swordsman while I stroke my shit. Yeah, what go? Yeah, oh yeah. Definition of rich man as I come fast. Blowing in your mouth and going in your ass, fleeing shit. As my fucking spit, all in her mouth is my motherfucking dick. Moving my dick like a motherfucking joystick. All in her pussy ass, if the fuck drips. Faster and faster as my fuck come at the tip of my dick as if the fuck.
You take a picture with your ass out and your back bent in with your pussy barely peeking through from a low angle with your face in it, winking with your tongue out and your feet in it, and your arches exposed and your toes clenched and your torso at three-quarters rotation with your side boob and your nipples just out of sight with a choker on and your panties around your waist with the middle pulled to the side.